Edward Snowden tweeted this out today. The most important video of the year was filmed in 1983. I wonder what this video is. I bet it talks about how the CIA has been and the establishment has been lying and controlling everything. And you're a chump if you think you live in a democracy. Let's see.
You briefed the press, did you not, when you were there?
Well, I had several jobs. One of my jobs was that of analyst. I also was an interrogator and indeed briefed the press when we, the CIA, wanted to circulate disinformation on a particular issue. Disinformation is not necessarily a lie. It may be a half-truth. And we...
You know, like ivermectin is used for horses. That was half a truth that became a full lie because it's also an award-winning, Nobel Prize-winning, WHO essential human drug. So that's what he's talking about.
Pick out a journalist. I would go do the briefing and hope that he would put the information in print. For instance, if we wanted to get across to the American public that the North Vietnamese were building up their force structure in South Vietnam, I would go to a journalist and advise him that in the past 6 months, X number of North Vietnamese forces had come down the Ho Chi Minh Trail system through southern Laos. Now, there is no way a journalist can check that information. So either he goes with the information or he doesn't, and ordinarily or usually, the journalist would go with it because it looked like some kind of exclusive. And I would say our percentage planning that kind of data was 70 to 80%. The correspondents we targeted were those who had terrific influence, the most respected journalists in Saigon, like Robert Chaplin of the New Yorker magazine, Kai's Beach of the Los Angeles Times from time to time, and also he worked for the Chicago Daily News. Bud Merrick of U.S. News and World Report, Malcolm Brown of the New York Times, even Maynard Parker of Newsweek magazine. We would go after these gentlemen. I would be directed to cultivate them, to spend time with them at the Caravelle Hotel or the Continental Hotel, to socialize with them, and slowly but surely to try to gain their confidence by dolloping out valid information, information which was true. And then I would drop in into a conversation the data that we wanted to get across, which might not be true. One piece of data, for instance, that we managed to plan in the New Yorker magazine had to do with a supposed North Vietnamese effort in 1973 to develop airfields along the border of South Vietnam. The reason we wanted to plant this information was that we were trying to persuade the U.S. Congress that Saigon should be continued to get a great deal of aid, and that the North Vietnamese were the chief violators of the ceasefire accord. That was printed in the New Yorker magazine under the byline of Robert Chaplin, as indeed was a great deal of such information which we trying to circulate. If I planted a piece of information with a reporter, I would ordinarily then try to create an environment in which he could not check the information. I would go to the British ambassador and brief him on the disinformation I had just given the reporter. So when the reporter wanted to cross-check what I told him with, say, the British ambassador, New Zealand ambassador, or what have you, he would get false confirmation, the same message coming back at him. He'd say, aha, I've got proof that Frank Snepp told me the truth, when in fact, what he'd gotten was simply an echo of what I'd given him in the first place via the British ambassador or other of our friendly diplomatic contacts. I am, as an ex-CIA agent, opposed to the disinformation activities in which I was involved. I admit that I was involved, and I think it served no useful purpose. Propagandizing the American public or Congress is not the CIA's job.
Well, of course, that guy's an idiot. Of course, that's their job.
what is their job if not that?
Of course, that's their job. So, again, the problem isn't randos on YouTube. The problem isn't me. The problem isn't randos on Twitter. It isn't Alex Jones. The problem is our own government is propagandizing us, and they always have. Right. By the way, Barack Obama got rid of the law that said they couldn't do it overtly.
This guy had to go behind the scenes.
So they don't even hide the CIA. Like the CIA used to infiltrate newsrooms, and they would corrupt journalists. Now they just put him on air. The head of the CIA just goes on CNN, just goes on MSNBC, just goes on Fox News, ABC, NBC, CBS. Yeah. The head of the CIA or the former director of the NSA or the head of the FBI. And they bring these guys on as if they're experts. Instead of checking them for lying, they're bringing them on to tell us what they consider the truth. Of course, they're lying. So everything you're seeing on MSNBC or CNN about a war or about Russiagate or about anything is a lie. And that's what Chomsky proved to us. Go ahead, Kurt.
Do you think that's when, like, remember Fox's big innovation of having, like, Ollie North as a correspondent?
Yeah.
Like, oh, we got to get a bunch of Ollie Norths to do that kind of
stuff.
Right.
That was just for ratings, right? Because Ollie North was popular. They don't give a shit about the fucking truth at Fox News or any other news organization. Hey, we're doing live stand-up shows in Austin, Texas, Burbank, California, the Saturday after Thanksgiving, and in Los Angeles. Go to jimmydorecomedy.com for a link for all our tickets and become a premium member. While you're there, you get access to all of our premium content unedited.